The term physiognomy means a person's facial features or expression, especially when regarded as indicative of character or ethnic origin. This is why when you look at some faces you get nice guy vibes and good guy vibes. This man looks like he got high strict morals. The complete opposite also applies to some faces. They look evil, untrustworthy, and have low moral standing. Of course, a person's face does not always reflect his character. But in some cases, it does, which leads us to analyzing the evil face of the nice talker, Richard Ramirez. The goal of this video is to target the weird phenomenon of women back in the 80s, 90s, and even currently gushing over him with Netflix documenting his crimes. And there is also a model who shares a similar appearance to the nice talker, Richard Ramirez. I will discuss him in the end as well. Like always, this video will be split into two main parts. Part 1 will talk about the attraction behind serial killers. And part 2 will talk about the nice talker facial analysis. If you want to support the channel and get your face evaluated by me with personalized look max and advice, link will be down in the description. If you want to read more about topics like these, you can check out my blog at nearfacerating.com. Without further ado, let's get this video started. Small disclaimer, not all women are attracted to such men, nor do I mean to glorify these men and their actions. So why are some women attracted to serial killers and criminals? Well, there are two sides to this argument, physical and mental. Physical is pretty obvious for both genders. If someone is facially attractive, we are going to be sexually attracted to them. Does not matter if they are a criminal or not. In fact, some people will overlook their horrid actions just for their looks, which matches up with the pretty privileged theory. Now let's move on to the psychological side, and of course we will look at some studies done on the subject. Study number 1 will talk about how criminals and antisocial men have more sexual partners and have sex earlier. A meta-analysis of the correlative criminal behavior by Ellis and Walsh in 2000 found a strong association between criminal behavior and a great number of reported sexual partners in men. 23 studies demonstrated a link between various forms of antisocial and criminal behavior and greater sex partner count, including delinquency, violent offenses, various offenses, victimful offending, antisocial personality, and conduct disorders. 20 studies found a link between illicit drug use and a greater number of sexual partners. Only one study examined failed to find a significant link between antisocial behavior and a greater lifetime sexual partner count. The authors also discovering a strong link between criminal antisocial behavior, drug use, and an earlier sexual debut in both sexes. 17 studies found a relationship between delinquency, various offenses, victimful offending, conduct disorders, and antisocial personality, plus an earlier age of sexual debut. 13 studies demonstrated a relationship between illicit drug use and an earlier age of sexual debut. Every study examined found relationships between criminal, antisocial behavior, and being sexually active at a younger age. The author also stated that earlier studies had convincingly demonstrated that self-reporting the number of sexual partners via an administered questionnaire had proven to be a reasonably accurate measure of actual partner count, especially for males. And the second study will talk about how imprisoned serial killers, terrorists, and our world received thousands of love letters from women. Hybristophilia is a sexual phenomenon that is defined as the erotic obsession with or exclusive sexual attraction with an individual who commits extremely heinous or violent crimes such as arson, murder, serial killing, etc. According to the research that has been conducted in regards to the matter, it is a phenomenon almost exclusively found in women. Here we have the names of some criminals who have received some love letters from women. We have famous names like Ted Bundy, Richard Ramirez, and Chris Watts. So now that we know a bit about the psychological side, let's take a look at the face of the night stalker himself. So what makes the face of Richard Ramirez look so scary and striking at the same time? Well, to keep things short, it's a mix of attractive ratios, aggressive lines, and an aggressive eye area. I usually start with the jaw, but let's start with the mid-face region. First of all, the zygomatic bones project horizontally with a bigonial to zygomatic ratio of 89 to 90%, which shows you just how much they project in contrast with the jaw width. This factored in with very, very low body fat percentage, resulting in very hollow cheekbones. In my opinion, way too hollow, which resulted in a gaunt and ghastly scary look. Next aggressive area of the face on top of the mid-face region is the eye area. Now his eyes is what I like to call aggressive almond-like hunter eyes. Not pure hunter eyes, because in some other photos, they are not fully hooded. For example, Henry Cavill got friendly almond eyes. For Richard's case, it's the opposite. This is all thanks to the very compact orbits, higher set cheekbones, vertically compact and horizontally elongated eyes, good upper jaw development, and genetics. And for the icing on top of the cake, they are deeper set into the skull and the brow ridge is decent in protrusion. And I forgot to mention, the eyebrows with their positive tilt. There are other ratios that are linked to how aggressive a face looks. For example, his FWHR or facial width to height ratio is around 1.86, which is more on the aggressive side. His mid-face ratio is compact, around 1:1. And finally, the jaw, which is important for men in terms of facial attractiveness, ticks all the boxes in terms of Richard's case. The jaw is well projected, ramus length is decent, the gonio angle is masculine, the bigonial width is wide with decent overall symmetry. Now, I will not measure other facial ratios, but trust me, they also fall within the attractive range. The purpose of this video was just to point out what makes his face look so damn aggressive. Now for the Easter egg I have discussed earlier, there is a model called Elias, he looks close to Richard. I will put comparisons on the screen. The point of this video was not to glorify any serial killers or praise their actions, just making myself clear just in case. What do you guys think? Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section. That's it for today's video, I hope you guys enjoyed it, a like and subscribe will be highly appreciated, and like usual, catch you guys in the next one.